Hello guys, welcome back to the Civil Engineering YouTube channel. Please subscribe our channel for daily Civil Engineering videos. Today our lecture is about the difference between the T-beam and the rectangular beam. I will explain this difference with the help of examples. Both these beams looks like T. As you can see here, the top is the like flange, as you can see in the T. This is the T alphabet T, in which we have in the top we have flange. In both cases we have flange and we have web and we have web here, similarly the web. So these two types of the beam looks like T, but their behavior and their analysis differentiate into two different categories. One is called the T beam and one is called the rectangular beam. So we should know that their shape looks like T. Both beams looks like T beam, but their difference is in their analysis and their design. One is designed as T beam and one is designed as rectangular beam. You should know the difference between these two types of the beams while analysis and designing. First of all, I will explain the rectangular beam. Let's consider that this is any slab. This is the slab which has been poured with concrete and reinforcement, and this is being supported on the beam, and there is no joint between the slab and beam. And let's suppose this is the beam with the cross section, and it is the reinforcement provided in the beam. So this beam supports the slab without any monolithic joint. As you can see here, there is no joint between the slab and beam to connect one another. So this makes is the rectangular beam. This is called is now rectangular beam. And it should be designed as the rectangular beam because of the section. The cross section of the beam is rectangular. So that's why we should analyze and design this beam as a rectangular beam. And this load, slab load, is act on this beam. And we will take into consideration the load of this slab which has been acting on this beam. This is the definition of the rectangular beam, that it should look like rectangular cross section, and there should no joint between the slab and beam, but it should act separately from one another. The slab act separately and the beam act separately. So the slab is being supported on the beam. In this case, the beam is castly first with the concrete, and then after hardening we place the slab on the top of the beam. So this is the this rectangular beam, and we have different analysis and designing of this rectangular beam. Now in case of the T beam, the beam and slabs are monolithically connected to one another. This is the slab and this is the beam. But in this case, in the case of the T beam, both the slabs and beams are connected to one another, and we call this joint is a monolithic joint between these two different members. And the beam reinforcement has been embedded into the slab. This is the straps of the beam, and this is the tension reinforcement. There's a compression reinforcement for the beam, and the beam reinforcement has been embedded into the slab, so it makes the real T beam or the actual T beam. Similarly, the slab reinforcement has been embedded into the beam reinforcement. So both these members act as one member, and slab take the load and transfer to the beam as one member, not like the in case of the rectangular beam where the beam supports the slab from above. But in this case, both these members act as one single member because we have the reinforcement of the beam embedded in the slab. Due to this connection that the reinforcement is being embedded into the slab, we have different analysis in analyzing the beam, and we have different designing of this type of the beam. And this is known as the monolithic joint between these two different members. This was the main difference between the T-beam and rectangular beam, where we have separation of the two different members. And this, well, in case of the T-beam, we don't have any separation, but we have embedment of the beam reinforcement into the slab and slab reinforcement into the beam. So they act like as one member, and they take the load, and they have different analysis and designing, while the rectangular beam have different analysis in designing beam. Hope you guys understand, and don't forget to subscribe my channel for daily civil engineering videos. Thank you for watching our video.